As Elon Musk quoted, "Space is really hard." Well, I think SpinLaunch now got a taste of what Elon meant by, yes, things are not going well for the most hyped orbital launcher.
Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started.
SpinLaunch was one of the most talked about crazy, but maybe startups in the new space ecosystem. The company promised to revolutionize space access, not with rockets, but with a giant centrifuge, a vacuum-sealed disk, spinning so fast that it could literally hurl payloads into the sky at hypersonic speeds. The concept was bold, simple in theory, and visually spectacular. Instead of using tons of propellant, SpinLaunch wanted to use kinetic energy to fling small satellites upward, reducing costs, fuel, and environmental impact. It sounded like science fiction finally turning real. But a few years later, the noise around SpinLaunch has faded into near silence. The company never reached orbit, never demonstrated a full-scale flight, and today, it has become more a cautionary tale of hype than a story of breakthrough innovation. So, what exactly went wrong? Why did SpinLaunch never get the chance to spin anything into space? The idea was born in 2014, when founder Jonathan Yanni proposed using a massive vacuum centrifuge to accelerate small payloads to several times the speed of sound before releasing them skyward. The system, according to company claims, could reduce launch costs by up to 70%, since the initial push would come from mechanical energy stored in a rapidly rotating arm powered by electricity rather than chemical propellants. Once the projectile reached the upper atmosphere, a small onboard rocket would ignite to complete the orbital insertion. In principle, it was an elegant mix of mechanical and chemical propulsion, one that could completely upend the economics of small sat launches. Over the next few years, SpinLaunch secured high-profile backers, including Google Ventures and Airbus Ventures, and eventually won contracts from NASA and the US Department of Defense to demonstrate its technology. Its prototype accelerator, a 33-meter-wide suborbital launcher, was built at Spaceport America in New Mexico. In late 2021, SpinLaunch released an impressive-looking video showing a projectile being launched from the centrifuge, soaring into the desert sky. It captured public imagination, with the footage going viral on social media. The company claimed that the test validated their concept and that they were moving toward a larger orbital-class accelerator over 100 meters in diameter. But beneath the flashy visuals and grand claims, experts were skeptical. The physics of SpinLaunch's concept raised immediate red flags. Launching an object at hypersonic speeds directly from a centrifuge involves enormous forces, not just from acceleration, but from air resistance a moment the payload exits the vacuum chamber. The payload would experience thousands of grams of acceleration, far beyond what most electronics, sensors, or even structural materials could tolerate. While the company suggested that ruggedized satellite components could be engineered to withstand the stress, that assumption was never convincingly proven. Even the casing and fairing needed to protect such a payload would have to survive both extreme centrifugal loads and the violent transition from vacuum to atmosphere. Another fundamental challenge lay in aerodynamics. When an object exits a tube at several times the speed of sound, it instantly slams into dense lower atmosphere air, creating immense shockwaves and drag. Without a rocket engine firing to guide or stabilize it, the projectile would tumble chaotically, losing both altitude and orientation before a secondary stage could ignite. Engineers noted that the energy loss from drag could erase much of the kinetic advantage that SpinLaunch promised. And even if the projectile somehow maintained integrity, the enormous noise and shock effects would likely prevent launches near populated areas, an operational constraint that added to costs and complexity. Still, SpinLaunch pushed forward, conducting a series of suborbital tests and claiming incremental success. The company insisted it had solved many of the design challenges by optimizing payload shapes, materials, and release mechanisms. Yet, no independent data was ever published. NASA's involvement, a test contract for launching small payloads, provided credibility but did not guarantee commercial viability. By 2023, reports suggested that SpinLaunch's funding was drying up, with limited visible progress toward building its full-scale orbital accelerator. The company had ambitious talk, but little tangible proof that its technology could scale beyond short-range demonstration flights. Another factor that hurt SpinLaunch was the rapid evolution of the small satellite launch market. When SpinLaunch began, small payload rockets were expensive and infrequent. Companies like Rocket Lab, Astra, and Firefly Aerospace were still finding their footing. But by the mid-19s, the launch landscape changed dramatically. SpaceX's rideshare programs, Rocket Lab's Electron, and even emerging air launch systems made access to orbit cheaper, faster, and more reliable. SpinLaunch was trying to solve a problem that was already being solved, just in a more conventional and scalable way. The market no longer needed an unproven high-risk centrifuge when cheap reusable rockets were already operational. Public perception also shifted. Early on, SpinLaunch presented itself as a disruptor, an underdog challenging traditional rocket science. But over time, it began to feel more like a publicity-driven startup, chasing attention rather than engineering breakthroughs. Critics pointed out the company's reluctance to release hard data or peer-reviewed results. The promotional videos looked great, but they showed suborbital flights of small inert projectiles, not actual satellite launches. The spin part of the name started to take on a double meaning, the hype cycle, spinning faster than the centrifuge itself. By 2024, the silence from the company was telling. While SpaceX was testing its massive, fully reusable Starship, and Rocket Lab was routinely reusing first stages, SpinLaunch's promised orbital flight within 2 years remained unfulfilled. Insiders reported that the engineering hurdles, particularly the survivability of payloads and the stability of releases, proved more daunting than anticipated. Building a centrifuge large enough to impart orbital velocities required not just enormous infrastructure, but also materials capable of withstanding incredible stresses. Every scale-up introduced exponential engineering challenges. Another issue was regulation. Launching a projectile at hypersonic speeds involves major safety and range safety concerns. Even a minor misalignment could send debris flying miles off course. And because the initial trajectory was purely ballistic, there was limited control in the first phase of flight. The FAA and other regulatory bodies would have demanded extremely strict oversight, potentially restricting launch frequency and increasing costs, further eroding the supposed advantage of low-cost access. In the end, the industry moved on. Reusable rockets achieved what SpinLaunch promised: lower costs, higher cadence, and cleaner technology, without reinventing the laws of physics. SpaceX's Falcon 9 landings, Rocket Lab's booster recoveries, and the emergence of space tugs and orbital transfer vehicles rendered the kinetic launch dream unnecessary. SpinLaunch, for all its ingenuity, became a footnote in the history of alternative launch concepts, remembered more for its spectacle than its success. There's still something admirable about what the company attempted. In a field often dominated by incremental progress, SpinLaunch dared to think differently. It tried to engineer a fundamentally new way to reach space, and in doing so, it reminded the world that radical ideas are worth exploring, even when they don't work out. But innovation is not just about imagination. It's about execution, scalability, and timing. SpinLaunch had imagination in abundance, but stumbled on the other three. And so, despite all the spin, it never truly got the chance to spin anything into space.
Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.